Hi children, welcome to the chemistry class. In the previous class we have discussed till valency and how the name is given to the elements according to the IUPAC. And next comes to the radicals. A radical is a group of atoms of element. A radical is a group of atoms of element that behaves like a single unit that shows positive and negative. Positive radical is NH4 and negative radical is hydroxide that gives the plus and minus signs. Next, let's see the radicals of monovalent electropositive, divalent electropositive. See here we discussed behaves like a single unit and shows a valency. What is a valency? Atom of an element sometimes may lose or may gain the electrons. That is valency. Here monovalent electropositive, divalent. See, mono means one. Means if it is getting one electron or lose electron, that is mono. Di means two. And tri means three. Tetra means four. Penta, five. Hexa, hepta, and then octa. So these are the chemical terminologies for the numbers. Monovalent, one. For example, ammonium. Ammonium NH4 plus. That is no. So one we cannot sign, right? So it will be taken as plus. Positive signs plus. If it is electronegative, then it will be taken as minus. And then copper Cu plus. Hydrogen H plus. Ion will write, so here it is monovalent, that is one. So instead of one, we'll just denote symbol, that is ion symbol plus. Here barium, calcium, ferrous, magnesium, here two electrons which can lose the electrons, that is Ag2 plus, Ba2 plus, Ca2 plus. So here the symbol instead of one we are not writing, so anywhere we'll not write one. Right, so for that we'll just write plus or minus, but for divalent we'll write the number. And then trivalent, trivalent electropositive, that is three. Aluminium Al3 plus, arsenic As3 plus, gold Au3 plus, bismuth Bi3 plus, ferric ion Fe3 plus. And then tetravalent electropositive, that is four, having four electrons, those are positively charged. See here, having positive polyatomic ions, means more than two, we'll say polyatomic ions, nitrate, nitrite, ortho, silicate, oxalate. So these are the examples, periodate, permanganate, peroxide, phosphate, pyrophosphate, sulfate, and then sulfite, thiocyanate, thiosulfite. So these are the electropolyatomic ions having plus and minus. Chemical formula. How we can give a chemical formula of a element? A molecule of a substance, that is element or compound, could represent by a symbol. A molecule of a substance, that is element or a compound, could be represented by say symbol. An element is referred to as monoatomic when it exists as a single atom. An element is referred to as monoatomic when exist as a single atom. If element exists in single atom, it is derived as a monoatomic. And chemical formula, a molecule of a substance or element or compound could be represented by symbols. That symbols are chemical formulas. A compound contains whole number of atoms of the component element, indicating that elements are in chemical composition and thereby representing its molecular formula. A compound contains whole number of atoms. A compound contains whole number of atoms of component elements, indicating that the elements are in chemical composition, thereby representing its molecular formula. See, compound molecular formula: methane CH4, ethane C2H6. For this atoms, how the models atoms arranged? See, elements like hydrogen, methane formula is CH4, that is one carbon and four hydrogen, and ethane C2H6, two carbon atoms and six hydrogen. Here see the molecule, how the carbon is blank. See, it is indicated blank, and black and hydrogen atoms are surrounded. And then molecular formula representations, how the molecular formula, structural formula, and then ball and stick models, space filling models. These are the two models derived for the structural and molecular formulas of an element. See, methane CH4, ammonia NH3, water H2O, oxygen O2. See, the bonds which are between them are planar bonds and hydrogen bonds between them. And see, the for CH4, C carbon and 4 hydrogen, and nitrogen and ammonia NH3, 1 nitrogen and 3 hydrogens. And for water, 1 oxygen and 2 hydrogen, and for oxygen, 2 oxygen atoms. This is a molecular representation. The hydrogen, see here, same kind of 4 hydrogen atoms, but 1 carbon, that forms a methane, which gives a chemical formula. Some of the characteristics of a compound. What are the characteristics of a compound? All compounds share some common properties which used to identify them. All compounds share same chemical properties which enables to identify them. Compounds are formed by chemical reactions which usually involve an exchange of energy, that is heat or light. When a compound is exposed to heat or light, the chemical reaction will be changed with the environment present around the compound. A compound has properties that are different from properties of constituent elements. For example, sodium chloride, that is salt, that is solid. When you see salt, it is a solid, but when you mixes with water or when you heat it, what happens? It turns into liquid. Yes or no? When turns into liquid, that means when you expose to heat or light, it will change the chemical reactions. That means it will change the form. It will change the form. See here, sodium chloride, different from sodium or chlorine, is sodium is solid and chlorine is gas. Usually the states, if we see the state, sodium is solid state, but chlorine is a gas. Chlorine, which we use for the water treatment also, for water purification also, it is a gas form. But when you mix it, sodium plus chlorine, it forms a sodium chloride, that is in solid salt which we use. It's a cooking salt which we use. So when you heat or when exposed to the light, the characteristic of compound will change. For example, take sugar also. Sugar is nothing but glucose, C6H12O6, but when you see it, it is in crystal form. But when you boil or heat or when you expose to heat, what happens? It turns into liquid. So one form to changing of one form to another form. So this characters will be remain same in some chemical compounds, but it changes when the chemical reaction takes place. See, compound, two or more different elements that are chemically combined is compound. Two or more different elements that are chemically combined forms compound. Chemical change, a change that produces one or more new substances with new chemical properties. For example, oxidation, burning, or any nuclear reactions that changes the substances and that produces a that substance with new chemical properties. A change that produces one or more new substances with new chemical properties. That is chemical change. If chemical properties produces with mixing of other substances, the chemical properties will differ. But physical change, a change which involve appearance of substance, change its chemical properties, say, remains same. Physical appearance will be the different, but the chemical change, chemical property will remain same. Face changes, shape, size may change, but the chemical property will remain same. That is the characteristics of a compound. In chemical reactions, a change produces when it reacts with other chemicals or any removal or addition of electrons or electrons. Removal of electrons, oxidation, any oxygen atom is added or removed, or any electron is added or removed, that changes the chemical reaction. But physical appearance, size, shape and face, solid to liquid, liquid to solid or gas, that may change, but the chemical property will remain same. So the about the next naming compounds, that will be continued in the next class. Thank you.